Okay guys, so today I'm going to cover another topic called tax on sales purchase. Tax on sales purchase. Now, what is this tax on sales purchase all about? So this is the configuration of indirect taxes. As we know, we are having two types of taxes: direct taxes, indirect taxes. Direct tax means whatever the TDS related configuration which we have done already, that is your direct tax. And indirect taxes means earlier we had VAT, CST, custom duty, excise duty. Instead of these all taxes, now we are having GST. The government of India is going to levy or apply GST on goods, and this tax is applicable on goods and services both. There are few highlights which I'll explain before proceeding towards configuration. So as I already said, like, tax on sales purchase is nothing but configuration of indirect taxes. Now here there are certain important highlights, and these are the, like, previous indirect tax regime was quite complex. Of course, if you talk about previous indirect taxes, see here, central and state government levied a large number of taxes such as central excise duty, then your service tax was there, VAT was there, VAT, purchase tax, central sale tax, entry tax, local body tax, octroi, so many taxes were there. Now, each of these an independent tax, and this create lots of complexities and difficulties for the taxpayers. Of course, because huge number of taxes are there, some tax are being collected by central government, some taxes are being collected by state government, even like in state government also some of the taxes was collected by, like, you know, this octroi or some local bodies and all. So it was really, the complexity was too much. Now, in order to ease, in order to reduce this complexities and all, what happened? Then central government brought this GST. GST concept was came into existence. So that's what I have specified here to simplify this tax regime. The goods and service tax was implemented across India, and GST is levied on both supply of goods and services. On both, whether you are going to supply goods or services, whether you are going to buy goods or services, on both, GST will be applicable. Now, the same thing has been explained here with a diagram. Like earlier we had, like, state government is having separate taxes. These are the taxes which I have already explained here. Central government was, you know, going to apply a different taxes. Central government was also collecting a different taxes. So these are the taxes. State government and central government all together, they used to collect several different taxes. Now, instead of these all taxes, what is going to be, instead of these all taxes, now we are having one unified tax, that is GST. We are having only one tax instead of all indirect taxes. Now we are having one tax, that is GST. Now, if you talk about GST, then GST, how GST is going to work, some brief explanation I'll be giving, and then we'll start our configurations, what we are going to do and how we are going to do, how we are going to map GST in SAP, that will be explained. But first of all, we'll let you know about GST. Now, so taxes under GST. GST stands for goods and service tax. Now, so if you talk about sales purchase and sales, in that, like, there are two types of goods movements are happening. Whenever purchase and sales is taking place, of course, some goods movement will be there. So two type of movements are there: intrastate movement and interstate movement. Now, what is this intrastate movement and interstate movement? So intrastate movement means when the sales and purchase is taking place within the state. Intra means within the state. Intrastate movement. So if the sales purchase has taken within the state, customer, buyer and seller both are belongs to the same state, in that case GST is going to be applicable. Now, what kind of GST will be there? Two GST will be charged. One is called CGST and second is called SGST. Two GST doesn't mean that. See, I'll tell you guys. And first of all, let me explain interstate also. Interstate means from one state to other state. Okay, sales and purchase is taking place and the goods movement, like goods is moving from one state to other state. In that case, what will happen? IGST is going to be applicable. IGST is called integrated GST. CGST stand for central GST and SGST stand for state GST. Now, so if you talk about within the state, when the goods movement is there within the state, sales purchase is taking within the state, then how the CGST and SGST is going to be applicable? So government has already defined the GST rates. Government has already defined the GST rate, that is 0%. 0% means GST exempted on few goods and services, which is like now which are which goods and services which is falling under exemptions, which comes under 5%, which comes under 12%, which comes under 18% and which comes under 28%. 28% means all luxury goods are coming under 28%. So this, lots of videos are there on YouTube. If you want to know about the goods and services which falls under these all slabs, there are huge videos are uploaded in each and every languages. You can just go through that and you can. So that is not a matter of our concern. Why? Because as a consultant, we are supposed to map these all things in SAP and we have to create our different this percentage tax codes. Okay. So how we have to map and how to create this tax codes and all, how the deduction is going to happen, how it is going to hit a different GL account. We have to concentrate on that. What is the, you know, like, which goods are coming under which slabs and all, that is the matter of, and that is the matter of concern for your end user. They knows and they are supposed to, but anyway, knowledge is better. If you know, it will be better for you guys also. So you can refer those videos later. You'll come to know which, you know, items or goods and services are coming under which category. So what is happening now here, the government of India already predefined these all slabs, 5%, 12%, 18%, 28%. Okay. Now, we'll take any one of the tax percentage and we'll explain. Now, let's suppose the middle one, 12%. Okay. Now, if we take 12%, then what will happen? Let's suppose any, you know, raw material is being purchased by your client, and on that, 12%. GST is applicable, like that material or that goods good is falling under 12% slab, 12% GST category. Now, so what will happen if that purchase, if that purchase or sales has taken place within the state? It means buyer is also in same state, seller is also in same state. So in that case, what will happen? GST is applicable, 12% GST itself, but what will happen? 6% CGST will be applicable and 6% SGST will be applicable. It means what is happening? Half of the tax is going to central government and half of the tax is going to be in the account of state government. So this is how central and state, you know, like, the tax percentage is 12% itself, but 6% we have to charge whenever, if you see the invoices, some invoices, like if you are going to purchase, like today itself, yesterday itself we bought LED, in that how since my window, in the sense the shopkeeper from where I bought this LED, that is also belongs to my city itself, and I am a local of this city. So what is happening when I bought this, what they applied? They applied what to say, CGST and SGST both. Okay, so CGST and SGST both. CGST, like it was coming under 28%, because if you go and buy the LEDs and all, so that is not belongs to your basic needs. So which, how much tax they collected? 28%. 28% means 14% they deducted as CGST and 14% they have deducted as SGST. Okay, so this is how you know what to say, GSTs are being applicable here if intrastate purchase and sales are there. If interstate purchase and sales is there, if interstate in the sense from one state to, if the goods movement is there from one state to other state, then in that case what will happen? In that case also, the same goods which we purchase here within the state, like the you know, transaction has happened, and now from one state to other state, in that case also 12% itself is applicable. In that case also 12% itself is applicable, but in that the format will be like the charge, they are going to collect this 12% as a integrated GST. Integrated GST, they will charge to 12% itself. So in both cases, whether it is you know, interstate or intrastate, in both cases what will be happening, GST percentage will remain unchanged. It will be always, if it is 0%, it means no tax. This is, the goods is exempted from tax. If it is 5% and if it is intrastate movement, then 2.5% will be collected as a CGST and 2.5% will be collected as a SGST. If it is interstate movement, then total 5% will be collected as IGST. Now, if it is 12%, then if it is intrastate, then CGST will be collected as a 6% and SGST will be collected as 6%. So total 6 plus 6, 12%. If it is interstate movement from one state to other state, in that case what will happen? In that case 12% will be collected as a IGST. So there is no change at all in percentage rates and all these things. They have simplified, and what to say, now here we are not going to discuss how they are going to, you know, apply for credits and all, because that is not our cup of tea. That will be like your client is going to, you know, do these all things, how they are going to apply for credits and all. Still, if you want to go in that much details and all, again I said, like, lots of what to say, explanations are there on YouTube, you can. So here we have to know how to map this GST in SAP, how this tax percentage should be also, you know, mapped in SAP, in the sense how this percentage will be calculated. And like let's suppose if it is intrastate movement, then this both should be collected, CGST and SGST should be deducted. I'll just give you a practical example. Let's suppose we are having, if here, say for example, if intrastate movement is there, then add CGST. I'm just taking example of 12%. So 6% will be CGST, and if and SGST will be also 6%. SGST also 6%. Now, if it is interstate movement, then the same tax is applicable as IGST, and how much? It is 12%. Okay, so this is how it should happen. So now, how we are going to map these all scenario in SAP? Now, what will happen? Here the client will say that if intrastate movement is there, then this 6%, this 6% goes to a different GL, and this 6% goes to a different GL. If interstate movement is there, then this 12% goes to a different GL, isn't it? Now, the requirement is going to be more and more complex when your client says that we are having two types of taxes. One is input tax and other is output tax. So guys, if you talk about input tax and output tax, input is your asset, and output is your liability. Whenever we are having any purchase, your vendor is going to apply some GST, so that will be treated as a input tax. It means GST input. And sales, so what will happen? This is output tax. On sales, we are going to, or your client is going to collect certain taxes, so that is output tax. Now, this input is our asset and output is our liability. Okay, so what will happen now? This CGST, SGST, IGST, these all transactions are going to hit a different GL. Now, further, they will say that you do one thing: whenever CGST and SGST is there, that of course this transaction should be posted in a separate GL. But in that also, if CGST input is there, SGST input is there, that should go to a different GL, and even in case of output also, it should goes to different GL, so that we can, at least we can, it is going to simplify us, that it will be a kind of, like, they will come to know like how much credit they are going to take. Like, let's suppose as an input they have paid 100 rupees, okay, and as an output they have received 120. So what they are going to, in a simple language, I am just making you understand, guys. So they have paid 100 rupees and they have collected 120 rupees. Now, if you talk about the payment to the government of India or their tax authority, how much they are going to pay? So this 120 is their output and 100 rupees is their input. It means 100 rupees they have paid to the vendor and 120 rupees they have received from customer. So in that case, what will happen? 120 minus 100. 120 minus 100. So what is the surplus amount? 20 rupees they are going to pay to the tax authority. Why? Because out of 120, 100 already they have paid. 100 already they have paid to a different vendors. But whichever vendors has received, they have to deposit these all things, they have to submit these all amounts to the government account itself. So this 100 rupees already they have paid. Now, out of 120, how much they are going to pay? Surplus amount 20 is there, that they are going to pay. It means 100 rupees credit they have taken. Now, that's what I am saying. Whichever 100 rupees they have paid to the vendor, this is not neither their expenses nor liabilities. What is this? This is their assets. Assets in the sense, even though we have paid this amount as a tax to the vendor, but this amount we are going to take as a credit. So this is why input tax we are going to treat as a assets. So now we'll talk about, so here what is happening? First of all, we are having two types of GST. GST like is applicable on interstate movement and intrastate movement. Intrastate movement means whatever GST percentage is there, that is going to segregate into part CGST and SGST. Whenever we are having this intrastate movement, whenever we are having the intrastate movement, in that case CGST and SGST is applicable, and interstate movement means IGST is applicable. In both cases, the tax percentage will remain unchanged. There is no any sort of differences in terms of, there is no any sort of differences in terms of tax percentage. 12%, 5%, 18%, 28% is applicable in both cases, interstate movement or intrastate movement. The only thing is like intrastate movement, we are going to segregate half and half, 50-50 in terms of CGST, and we have to collect whatever the tax percentage is there. 50% will be collected by in form of CGST and 50% will be collected by in form of collected in form of SGST. So this is all about GST. Now how we are going to map this GST in SAP, how it is going to map, what to say, how it is going to hit a different GL account, how to create these all percentage rates and all. Okay, so this will be covered. Now if you talk about configurational point of view, then these are the steps which we have to follow. These are the steps which we have to follow. Now what is the use of these all steps, I'll let you know guys. Okay, so we'll start from one by one, creation of condition types and all, why we are going to create these all things, that you'll come to know once we complete the configurations. So let me log in first. Okay, so now here I logged in. So we'll start the configuration one by one. Okay, so here the first configurations, define condition type and transaction code is OBQ1. Okay, so why we have to define condition types, what is the use of this condition types and all, that I'll let you know. First of all, let me define this condition types. Now so guys, if you talk about conditions, how many condition types we are going to define? So see here, if you see, we are having an intrastate movement, central GST, state GST, and interstate movement, integrated GST. So 1, 2, 3, these three condition types we have to define separately. Why we are going to define separately? Because separate calculations will be happening. CGST separate percentage will be there, SGST separate percentage will be there if it is intrastate movement, and if it is interstate movement, then IGST a separate percentage will be there. Okay, so which is why we are going to create three condition type. Okay, now here what is happening, but as I said, like we are having input tax and output tax. So input tax is a different one, that is our assets, and output tax is a different one, that is our liability. So now this CGST, SGST, IGST, we are going to create as a condition type. Now here CGST for input, CGST for output also, SGST for input, SGST for output also, and here IGST for input and IGST for output also. So how many condition type we are going to create? Total 6 condition types we have to create. Now if you talk about input and output, the transaction code is OBQ1. Now here give MWAS and MWVS. So what is happening, already SAP has given a standard condition types for input and output, that is MWAS for output and MWVS for input. See here, MWAS for output and MWVS for input. So what exactly we do, just copy this one. First of all, let's suppose how many condition types we are going to create. So here we are having three condition type, just remove this one and bring this IGST here. So this is in case of input, and the same we have to create in case of output also. Okay, so what we are going to do, we'll give different nomenclature and codes also we have to give here. So now copy this and your 4-digit code will be there. Okay, so what will be the 4-digit codes? This will be like CGST, SGST, IGST. Now here we'll do one thing. Then we'll make it like CGSI, SGSI and IGSI, so that it will be central state and integrated input, and instead of output we are going to remove T and we give O. So CGS, I'll just keep here CGSI, and here we'll keep CGST input tax. Okay, CGST input, we'll keep CGST input. Okay, and then press enter. And you can copy this one itself. So now we have to make it S, SGSI, and here also just make S. So SGST input, press enter, and here we can copy once again this one, copy, and here we are going to make it I, and here also IGST input, and then press enter. So save this. So now what we have done, we have created three condition types for central GST, state GST, integrated GST, that is CGST, IGST and SGST we have created. Now we have to create in case of output also. For output also we have to create three condition types. So for that MWAS is there. MWAS is there for output. Here copy this one, and here we have to make it, instead of CGSTI we are going to make it O. Okay, and here CGST output, we'll make it output. Okay, and then press enter and copy this one, and here SGST output, so SGSO, and here also SGST output, so SGS, simply S I have added, and press enter. Now one more we have to create, that is integrated, so just make it I, and here also we have to add I itself, so IGST input. So now what we have done, we have created six condition type. What are those condition types? We have created for input three condition type, and output also we have created three condition type. The condition type, that code we have given, CGSI, IGSI, sorry, CGSI, SGSI and IGSI, and here for output we have given CGSO, IGSO and SGSO. Why we have removed T? Because we are having, like in code we can give maximum 4-digit code, so that's what I have removed. Tax means T, and I added I and O so that we can easily differentiate which one is input condition and which one is output condition. Input condition and output condition, this is how we can levy. Input conditions will be applied, guys, whenever we are going to purchase any goods and your vendor has applied any GST on that. So that taxes, whichever you paid, that is your input, and whichever we are going to receive from customer, that is your output. Okay, we'll let you know while testing end user transaction posting. First of all, we have to do configuration. So what we have done, the first configurations I have done, the first configuration is define condition type. How many condition type I have created? I have created six condition type. Three I have created for input and 3 I have created for output. Now here this MWVS is for input and MWAS for output, which is standard condition type given by SAP. So simply we have to copy, we have copied both and we have created our condition type. Now create or copy transaction key. What is the use of transaction key, guys? Okay, now I'll tell you here the requirement from client side, that whenever intrastate movement is there, so that intrastate movement in that CGST and SGST is getting collected. Let's just take example of 12%, only one. Okay, remaining you guys can configure very easily. I'm going to tell you all the procedures. If we are able to create 12%, you can create 5% also, 18% also, 28% also, will be a kind of assignment for you guys. Okay, it's a matter of minutes only, because tax percentage only we need to create. How to create that, that also I'm going to cover later. Before that, we have to do lots of configurations. So now in case of intrastate movement, CGST and SGST need to be collected, 6% CGST and 6% SGST. An interstate movement, IGST, that will be 12%. So if the client says that whenever we collect this CGST, it should go to differential. For SGST, it should go to differential. IGST go to differential. Or else further, they say CGST in case of input will be hitting a differential. SGST in case of input will be hitting a differential. Again, CGST in case of output. Output in the sense when we are going to receive from customer, that should hit a different GL, and SGST in case of output, that should hit a different GL. Now here we are not going to discuss why different GL. Okay, I'm just explaining the scenario which can be given by client. Okay, that is their headache, that if they will be having different you know calculations and all, and in order to simplify their all this transactions calculation or credit calculations and all, they will decide whether they want to use a different GL for input and output, or they want to use one GL itself. So I'll just take the complex scenario. If I cover the complex, then whatever the easy scenario will be there, that is anyway you guys can do very easily. The most complex scenario will be like two different GLs. They will say that CGST in case of input a different GL, in case of output a different GL. Then in case of SGST, in case of input, the transaction should be posted in a different GL. In case of output, the transaction should be posted in a different GL. IGST also, in case of input, the transaction should be posted to a different GL. And in case of output, the transaction should be posted to a different GL. So in that case, 6 GL need to be created. Okay. So that's how it is going to hit to the different. Then the transaction is going to hit a different GL account. Okay, so now what we have to do, we have to create 6 GLs, because whenever we calculate, whenever the tax are being deducted, that is going to hit certain GL. So those GLs need to be created. Now how many GLs required to be created, it depends upon client. If the client says for CGST 1, input output in both cases 1, SGST input output in both cases 1, and IGST input output in both cases 1, then total 3 GLs we have to create. Now if the client says that in input and output different GL, then total 6 GL we are going to create. So here the next step will be creation of GL. Creation of GL account, we are going to use FS00. So first of all, we'll create 6 GL. Okay, we'll create 6 GL. Use transaction code FS00. Now we are going to create 6 GL as per the requirement. Okay, so now we came to FS00 transaction code, and here we have to create 6GL. So first we have to create for input and then we can create for output. So as I said, input is your assets. So here we are going to create. You can copy any GL because it's a simple GL which we are going to create. Let's suppose you see just till 1004 we have created. So what is the next GL number? 1005. Press enter. I simply copied this HDFC. Now what I am going to do, I'll change the text. So here we can create like CGST. Okay. Input account means this is central GST, central goods and service tax input GL. Remaining all the settings will be same. It's the part of assets, and whatever the other settings are there, we are not going to change because the same setting is applicable. So what we have created, CGST input account. In the same way, just copy CGST and make it 1006. Why? Because till 1005 we have created here. So make it the next GL number will be 1006. Now here, after CGST, we have to create SGST also. So give here S and here also S and then save this. That's it. Remaining all the settings will be same. So SGST input account we have created. Now we have to create IGST also. So copy this one and make it the next GL number should be 1007. Why? Because till 1006 we have created. So 1007, press enter and just create IGST. It means give here I and here also I and save it. So this is how we have created 3 input GL. Now we have to create output. So output will be our liability. So that we have to create under liability account group. Now in liability we are having only one GL, that is 2000. So what we'll do one thing. We'll just copy this CGST or SGST or IGST, anyone, just copy this. Now see the GL number. In liability we are having 2000, only one GL I have created. So what is the next GL number? This should be 2001. So make it 2001. Okay, and press enter. Now here change your account group liability, or else if you guys want to create a new GL, then you can click on here and create a new GL. Now here what is happening, CGS input is there. Now we'll do one thing, CGST output. CGST output account, control C and control V. Remaining all the settings will be remain unchanged. There is nothing we are going to be changed. So now we have created the first output, that is CGST output. Save this. And now we can copy this CGST output and we are going to create SGST. So what is the next GL number? Till 2001 we have created. So the next GL number 2002. Now here we have to just add S here, S and here also S. So we have created SGST output tax output, and we have to create one more. So once again select SGST or CGST, anyone, and what is the next GL number? Till 2002 we have created. So next GL number is 2003. Press enter. And here we have to create IGST. So give here I and here also I and then save it. So now whatever the required GLs are there, those GLs we have created, 3 input and 3 output. So 1005, 6, 7, that is our input GL, and 2001, 2, 3 is our output GL. Now here, so here if the requirement from client side, that each and every transaction should hit a different GL account in case of input and output. So that's what we have created, 6 GLs. Now, what next? So the next is, now create or copy transaction key. What is the use of transaction key, guys? Why we are going to create or copy this transaction key? I'll let you know. First of all, use transaction code OBCN. Just open on your screen and use transaction code OBCN. Press enter OBCN. And then we are going to copy. Why? Because for input and output already SAP has given, that is VST for input. See here, so copy first VST, copy VST. Okay, now here instead of VST, so here 3-digit codes we have to give. Okay, so now we'll do one thing, we'll make it just, we'll make it like C GST, I GST, and so CGI. Okay, because only three digit code is there, so we have to differentiate like some input and in case of input and output. So CGI, and here we can keep like CGST input. So CGI I have created, and again copy CGI, and here we can make SGI, and here SGST input. Press enter, and again copy this one, and here we are going to create IGI for integrated GST. We have created this account key IGI. Press enter and save it. So these three we have created. Now for output, we have to use MWS. Let's see. It should be MWS and BST. So MWS supposed to be there, but I think somebody has made some R&D. Let's see any other output tax is there. It means somebody has deleted. Okay, now we are having another output. So any output we are going to copy here. And even if you want, if you're not having, then you can create also with the same. You can create also in the sense like here new entry is there. We can create new entry, click on new entry, and then we can create, or is whatever the output tax is there, you can copy simply. Generally we will have, you'll be having, for output we are having MWS, that is a code which is given by SAP. So most likely in your server it will be there. In this server somebody has deleted, that is why it's not appearing. So now here we are going to create output. So for output, again we are having CGST, IGST, SGST. So for CGST, CGO, that is for output. And here again CGST output. Press enter. What we have done, CGST output. Okay, this one CGO. Now copy this one and here make it S so that it will be state. Press enter. cancel this, why it is coming. Anyway, save this and we'll create one more, that is integrated GST. So copy this one and make it I. Here it should not come. Right, where is our CGST and SGST? Sorry, CGS, CGO. Okay, so CGO, SGO. Now copy anyone once again because we have to create I, GO also. So here, I, GST, press enter and copy, cancel this. IGO has been created. Something went wrong. This is why it's coming. So here what we have done, we have created IGO and CGO, SGO. So whatever the transaction key is required, those transaction key we have created. How many transaction key we have created? We have created 6 transaction key. So guys, keep in your mind, 6 condition type we have created, 6 GL we have created and 6 transaction key we have created. Now what is the use of transaction key? So in one line, I'll say here right now that whatever GL we have created right now, these all GLs are going to be assigned against transaction key. Okay, all GLs are going to be assigned against transaction key. So whenever you post any transaction, whether it is purchase or sales, and let's suppose if there is any sort of deductions related to GST, if it is input or output, so how system is going to hit these all taxes to separate GLs? It's because of transaction key itself, because we are going to link the GL against transaction key itself. So now how to link the GL against transaction key, that also will be shown, and how it is going to work out, that complete logic I'll explain once we complete our configuration, how system is going to identify GL. Logically, if you see, it's very easy. I'll tell you once again guys, 98% of the entire candidates are not able to understand this logic, and which is why once they go for interview, their faces will be blank. Okay, but I'll let you know the logic, which is very simple. I'll try to make it more and more, I'll try to simplify so that it will be easy for you guys to understand. Now, so we have created transaction key also. Now assign GL account. Now the next step is we have to assign GL accounts. So where we are going to assign GL accounts, whatever GL accounts we have created, those GL account we are going to assign against this transaction key. Okay, against this transaction key. So OB40 is, now what transaction key we have created? I have created, like for input we have created, let's suppose CGI. Okay, again SGI and IGI. This is for input. For output, what we have done? CGO, SGO, and IGO. IGO. Why I have given I and O? Because so that we can identify which one is for it, input and which one is for output. And CG, SG, IG, we can understand this is for central, CGST, SGST, IGST, and here also the same thing. So now for this, CGSI, SGSI, and IGSI. CGSI, it means input. How many input we have created? If you see here, we have created total 3 input for CGST 1, SGST 1 and IGST 1. So CGSI means CGST input. So 1,567. Now here, just close this. So here 1,567. The same here, 1,005. Okay, here percentage is coming. So I'll do one thing. I'll just make it general itself. Okay, 1005, 1006, 1007. These three GLs will be assigned, because for CGST, actually I'll just tell you guys. See here, why we have so. This is what we have done. Okay, so here again for CGST input, SGST input and IGST input. So these are the GL we have created, and for this input, these are the condition, sorry, transaction key we have created. Or see here, these are the transaction key we have created for input, three transaction key and three GLs also we have created, 1005, 1006, 1007. For output, once again we have created three GL. What are those? 2001, 2 and 3. Okay, see here, CGST, SGST, IGST, 2000, 1, 2, 3. So what we are going to do now, against this transaction key, 2001, 2002 and 2003. So don't miss the sequence, always it should be CGS, SGS, IGS. In the sense, central goods and service tax, state goods and service tax, integrated goods and service tax. So this is how we have to map the GL. Now this I have given to simplify. So against these are our transaction key and these are our GL which we are going to map. Now use transaction code OB40/NOB4040. Okay, now here what we are going to do, now here you have to search where we have created this, whatever our transaction key, like C, GI. So you see here whether it is appearing or not. So these are the transactions. Now see here, we are having CGI, CGO, and we will be having CGS also. CGI is there. And then we will be having SGI. The first thing is like, we'll check from here itself. The first GL 1005 we have to assign against CGI, that is central GST. So where is CGI? Here it is CGI. Double click on CGI. And chart of account TM10 will be there. You have to check whether your chart of account is appearing or not. So always your chart of account will be suggested by system. If it is suggesting a different chart of account, then you have to change it manually. Press enter. And now here what you have to do, click on save button. Once you click on save button, then you have to give your number. CGI means what is the GL account? See here, 1005. So what we are going to do, we are going to assign here GL account 1005 and just check on posting key. Posting key not defined. So what you have to do, remove the GL account and then click on posting key. Remove the GL account and then click on posting key, and then here debit 40 and credit 50. Okay, and then click on accounts. Okay, do you want to save? Yes, I want to save. Enter. And then here 1005, and then we have to save it. Okay, now so we have given our GL account against CGI. Come back, now we have SGI. So where is SGI? Now just paste down, because these all are alphabetic here. See, you have to see here, this transaction, see alphabetic wise coming. So still R, we have to search S. So where is SGI? See here, SGI is there. Okay, so double click on SGI. Now here what you have to do, just click on posting key. Okay, do you want to save first? Yes. So I click on this one, then click on posting key. And first of all, you have to give 40 and then give 50 and then click on accounts. Do you want to save first? Yes. Then press enter, then click on, then account is automatically coming. Here 1006 we have to give for SGI. 1006, if you see here SGI 1006 is there. So give 1006 and save it. So what we are going to do, we are going to link our GL, we are going to assign our GL against account key. Now next one is IGI. So IGI will be upper side itself. In this, see alphabetic is there. So you have to search where is IGI. So it will be around here, IGI, it's here. Double click. And once again, either you have to save and then click on posting key and then give 40. Then here you have to give 50. And once you click on account, system will say that you want to save. Yes, I want to save. And then press enter button. And here 1007 we have to give, because for IGI, what is our GL account which we have created? That is 1007. This IGI represent integrated GST input. Integrated GST input. And for that we have created GL number 1007. So these all input GL we have assigned. Now it's time to assign output GL. So input GL till 1007 we have assigned. Now select output GL. So again CGSO. So you just come up and see where is CGSO. Sorry, CGO. So here is CGO, CGST output. So double click on CGO and here you need to save this. And after saving, click on posting key and give here 40 and then 50. That is debit and credit posting key. And then you need to save it, or else if you click on account, then system automatically is going to ask whether you want to save or not. Click on yes, that I want to save. And then here you have to give the first GL. What is for output? The first GL is for CGO 2001. So here what we are going to do, 2001. Okay, and save this once again. Press enter, click on back button. Now what is our next, this one, what is the next condition we have created? That is, sorry, what is the next transaction key we have created? So that is SGO. This is for CGST. Now we are having SGST. That is, SGST means SGO. Now search here, where is SGO? So alphabetic, serialized, we are going to search SGO. Double click on SGO. We found this. Click on save button and then click on posting key and then here 40 and then here 50 and then click on account. System is going to ask, do you want to save? Yes, I want to save. Click on yes, press enter. And here for SGO, what is the GL account which we have created? It is 2002. 2002 is our GL account. So assign 2002 GL and save this. Press enter button and click on back button. Now we are going to assign one more GL, that is 2003 against IGO. So for IGO, IGO starting from I. So it will be, will have to come up. And here search, where is IGO? Still it's not there. Now here it will be somewhere, IGO, it's here. So double click on IGO. Once again click on, click on save button. And then click on posting key. Once again you have to give your posting key debit 40 and credit 50. And then click on account. System is asking, do you want to save? Yes, I want to save. So click on yes button once again, press enter button, and then you have to give 2003, the GL account which we have created for IGO. If you see here, 2003 we have created for IGO. Now what we have done, we have assigned this GL account. Press enter. So now we have done with the GL account assignment. The next step, what is that? We'll see here. So now here we have copied transaction key, and against that transaction key, what we have done? We have assigned the GL account. So if somebody asks what is the use of transaction key, so you have to say it's transaction key which is going to transaction key responsible to identify GL accounts. Okay. Now we'll explain the complete logic once again once we complete the configuration. Now we have to see a next configuration, create tax procedure. So guys, now whatever things we have created, now we are going to arrange these all things here in tax procedure. Now I'll do one thing. So in order to create tax procedure, you have to use the transaction code OBQ3. Now here /NOBQ3. This is our transaction code by which we can create our tax procedure. Now here, what we have to do, click on new entry and you can create your tax procedure. So any code you have to give. Okay, so you give a kind of code which is identical. So our company code is TM10. I'm going to give that code itself so that it will be easy for you guys to identify. And here, tax procedure for TM10, press enter button. Now select this tax procedure and click on control. Now here the major configuration we are going to do. So what exactly we are going to do? So guys, this is our calculation procedure. Okay, how the tax is going to be calculated, those I'll explain here. Now click on new entry, and in the steps you have to give like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or is 10, 20, 30, or 100, 200, 300, like that people give. You can give anyone, like let's suppose 100, then 200, then 300, 400, 500, 600. And one more we have to give 700. Why I am giving this, I'll explain. Okay, then condition type. So here condition type, the first condition type you have to give BASB, and then we are going to give whatever our condition types we have created. What are the condition types we have created, guys? See, if you see here, I'll just show you guys here. Condition type we have created for CGST, we have created like CGSI. For SGST, what we have created? SGSI. For IGST, IGSI. Now for this is for input and output, again CGSO. And here SGSO and IGSO. These are the condition types which we have created. Now I'll do one thing. I'll just delete this. So now I'll just copy this and I am going to paste here. So all are appearing here. And if you press enter button, see automatically all these descriptions are appearing. All the descriptions are appearing. So what is the use of this? Now here, say for example, if you say for example, we are having an invoice. We are having an invoice worth of 100 rupees. If we are having an invoice, so here what is happening? Let's suppose we are having an invoice worth of 100 rupees. Okay. Now, so on 100, 12% GST. So what will be the? It will be right. 12% GST means 12% GST means it will be 12 rupees as GST. Now this 12% is going to be calculated on 100 rupees, right? So this 100 is called base amount. This 100 is called base amount, and this 12% is your tax amount. Okay. Now it is a different thing that this 12%, once again, like if it is like intrastate movement, then 6% CGST and 6% SGST, like that it will be counted, that is going to be calculated. But I'm just explaining you what is called base amount. So base amount is 100. So now whatever these taxes has, whatever these taxes are going to be, you know, calculated, this will be always calculated on base amount itself. Always it is going to be calculated on base amount. If you talk about the previous the tax procedure, that was going to be very much critical. Why? Because in the previous tax procedure, what will happen, the people will have like 100 rupees, let's suppose invoice amount is there, on that like some 10 rupees will be the tax amount, and again some additional tax will be there. Okay, that is called like whatever surcharge is there, like surcharge is nothing but tax on tax, cess, that is called cess, like Krishi Kalyan cess, Swachh Bharat cess. So our government of India is extremely fond of, you know, using cess and all. There might be a chances that on GST also they can bring some different kind of experiment they can do, and they can bring some additional taxes and all. But maybe in future, we don't know what will happen in future. We'll talk about present itself. If it is happening in future, then again we'll have to modify the tax procedure. So now here the base amount is 100. It means, let's suppose your invoice amount is 100, and on that 10% tax we are going to charge. 10% whatever the tax is there, whether it is VAT or whatever the means, I'm talking about earlier. So 10% tax they have charged, and let's suppose 2% they will add additional tax, that is called cess. So here cess is nothing but cess is going to be calculated on tax amount. So for this 10%, this is your base amount, and for this 2%, this is your base amount. Okay, so the calculation procedure was bit complex, but right now what is happening, right now we are not having this cess kind of funda here, we are having only one, that is GST. In that different percentage are there, but whatever percentage are there, all the percentage are going to be calculated on base amount itself, guys, keep in your mind. So now what is happening here, see, we have already, like whatever the condition type we have created, that is already given. Now here, so here all the conditions we have given. Now, so what is this? As I said here, that whatever our GST is there, whether it is CGST, SGST, IGST, or in that also, if you are going to more deeper, then in that case, like CGST input, SGST input, IGST input, or like all GST output also, these all are going to be calculated on base amount itself. Okay, if it is 12%, then 6% and 6%. This 6% is going to be calculated on this amount itself. Another 6% will be like whatever 6% and 6%. These all will be calculated on this amount itself. It means all the calculations are happening on base amount. So what will happen here? Now, this is our base amount. Now here, this is our calculation procedure, guys. Okay, we are going to create our calculation procedure. So here, if you talk about CGST input, this CGST means central GST, that is going to be calculated on which amount? That is going to be calculated on base amount. So see here, base amount step 10. So here, sorry, 100. So here you have to give 100. It means CGST will be calculated on which? On base amount. It means on 100. Again, SGST, also will be calculated in case of input. That is also going to be calculated on base amount itself. It means all GSTs are going to be calculated on base amount itself. Okay, so I am given 100, 100, 100. Okay, so this is the use. Now I have given 100, 100, 100. Okay. Now, one more thing we are going to do. If CGST is getting calculated, let's suppose 6%, or in case of 12%, it will be 6% and 6%. In case of 28%, 14% and 14%. So whatever percentage are getting calculated, then this amount should hit certain GL account. Okay, so which GL account it is going to hit? So CGST input. Now see here, these are our condition types. So this is going to hit this GL account. This CGST input is going to hit this GL account. SGST input is going to hit this GL account. And this is going to hit this GL account. Likewise, these all output is also going to hit the respective GL accounts here. Now, these all GL accounts we have linked against account key. See here, all GL account we have linked against account key. So what will happen? This account key we are going to link in tax procedure, tax calculation procedure. This account key we are going to link in tax calculation procedure. Where? Here. See here, account key. Okay, so here simply I am going to paste this. See how it is appearing here. For CGST input, we have created account key CGI. For SGST input, SGI. For IGST input, IGI. In the similar way, for again CGST output, so CGO, SGO, IGO. And in that account key, what we have done? We have already linked our GL account. So now our tax calculation procedure, configuration of tax procedure is completed. Save this. Save this. So now that this configuration got saved. Now here, what we have to do? We have to follow the next step. Assign tax procedure to country. Guys, why we are going to assign this tax procedure to country? Why? Because the tax procedure, whichever we have created, the calculation procedure will be applicable at country level. It's not like company code level. It's not like that for your company code, different GST calculation will be there, and for other company code, different GST calculation will be there. This calculation, whatever tax percentages are there, whatever the calculations is there, whatever the tax percent, percentage has been defined or given, that is given by central government, that is given by government of India, or that is given by a government of particular country. That is why if you talk about tax percentage and all, this is applicable at country level. In entire India, the same percentage will be there. Every company has to follow the same percentage rate. Okay, every company code has to follow the same percentage rate. So that is the reason we are going to assign our calculation procedure or tax procedure to country, because whatever the tax percentage are there, that is applicable at country level, not at company code level. Okay, it, what does it mean? Okay, so now as I said, like tax this calculation procedure or procedure is there, whatever tax procedure is there, that is going to be assigned at country level. Why? Because whatever calculation is happening, that is happening at country level, not at company code level. It means the calculation percentage or the calculation way of calculation does not differ company code to company code. Okay, it will be unified tax is there, unified tax percentage is there, that will be applicable to all company code. That is why which is going to be in a particular country, like in India, whatever the company codes are there, for all company code the same tax procedure is going to be applicable, and the same percentage will be applicable. So that is why we are going to assign our tax procedure against a country code. So how to assign this tax procedure to the country code? We are having transaction code OBBG. See here, OBBG transaction code is there. Use this transaction code, open a new screen here, and use transaction code OBBG. Okay, OBBG is your transaction code. And here, click on position and search your country. Give IN. Press enter. So here somebody is already assigned their tax procedure. Now what we are going to do, whatever tax procedure we have created, that we are going to assign and save this. So very simple step, nothing is there in this. Simply we have assigned our newly created tax procedure against our country. Now what is the next step? The next step is we have, now in the this step we have assigned our tax procedure. The next step is creation of tax code, which is very important, guys. I'll just show you how to create tax code. Okay, just see how to create tax code. So now let's suppose, I'll tell you, we'll just take an example of one, that is 12%. Okay, that is 12%. 12% means what? How many 12% tax code, tax, you know, what to say, code we have to create? Okay, so or anyone, 5%, 12%, 18%, 28%, okay, 0% also we have to create, but 0% tax code we will be creating later. Once I start asset management, there we need to create 0% tax code. So there we are going to create 0%. Right now we are not going to create. 0% is nothing but like exemptions. Okay, there are certain goods and services which is exempted, which is out of this tax, like tax is not applicable. So for those things we are going, we need to have 0% tax code anyway. Now so, and we have to take example of anyone. I'm just taking example of 12%. So now let's suppose 12% tax code, if you have to, then 12%, how many 12% tax code need to be created? See, I'll tell you, 12%, if we are having 12%, then 12% input and 12% output also. Okay, first of all, two tax codes are there, 12% input and 12% output. Now if you talk about 12% input, then if it is intra-state movement, then we have to create 12% in two different way. 6% for CGST and 6% for SGST. And if it is interstate movement, then 12% as IGST. Now how to create this, I'll just let you know, guys. We'll do one thing. We'll use transaction code FTXP. FTXP. This is the transaction code to create your tax code. Give your country, IN, press enter, and then here we are going to create the tax code. Now we'll do so I'll tell you guys one thing here. We can use a different this one. So see, generally what is the rule, whatever the tax codes are there, input tax code. So see here, for input, generally what will happen, or is, we'll do one thing, input and output. So input I and output O. Okay, so input here we have given I, and let's suppose we are going to create 12% or anyone, 12% itself. Okay, for 12%. So two digit code we have to give. Two digit code we have to give. Like I have given I1. Okay, press enter. And here you have to give, let's suppose 12%. 12%. Let's suppose I'm going to create 12%. Which GST? 12% GST, we can give a description like 12% CGST plus SGST, and this is input. Okay, you can, if you want, you can give a bracket also. Here, input. This 12% CGST and SGST, And input means if you click here on this drop down, for input we have to select V. See here, we are having two input means V. Double click on V and then press enter. Now see our all condition types which we have created, that is appearing here. Now 12% CGST, IGST and that too input. It means these three conditions are there for input. Okay, and these three conditions are for output. So 12% means 6% CGST and 6% SGST. So what we are going to do, in front of CGST we are going to give 6 and in front of SGST we are going to give 6. So what will happen, press enter and remaining whatever the lines are there, you can select this one and deactivate. You can select this one, deactivate, select this one, deactivate another line, select this one and deactivate. Now so what we have done, the tax rate will be 12% whenever we are going to purchase anything. Let's suppose, and if the intrastate movement is there, then 12% GST will be applicable. But in 12%, 6% we have to charge as CGST and 6% we have to charge as SGST. This 6% amount should goes to a different GL, and this 6% amount should goes to a different GL. So in that case, what will happen? So what we have done, we have already defined a different condition type, and that is why here 6% I have given and 6% here also I have given. Now what will happen? These all 6% and 6%. So if we are having intrastate movement, then we have to select tax code I1. If you select tax code I1, then what will happen? Automatically system is going to break this 12% in these two, 6% and 6%, and both are going to hit a different GL. If you see here tax account and give your chart of account TM10, press enter. See here, we are having two different GLs are coming. Okay, and I'll let you know once again once I post the transaction. So I have created one tax code 12%, one tax code I have created for 12%. In case if it is intrastate movement is there, and that too for input, another tax code in case if we are having interstate movement, that is a 12% tax code for integrated GST. So for that we are going to create one more, that is I2. Let's suppose I have created I2 and press enter, and here 12%, here we can create like IGST, and this is also input itself, IGST input. So input means here you have to give V. Input means V. If you click on drop down, you'll come to know input means here you have to select tax type V. Okay, so this tax type is going to differentiate whether the tax percentage which is going to be deducted is input or output. Press enter button once again, and here this 12% is your IGST. Okay, so IGST input, it means where it is here, IGST input, here we have to give 12%. Okay, press enter, and remaining all you can apply, like you can deactivate. This one also you can deactivate, other things also you can deactivate. Even if you don't do also, system will take it. Now here what is happening? So 12% simply we have created, in case of interstate movement is there, so we are going to charge IGST. So this 12% we are going to define here, and whatever GL is going to, whatever GL is linked, see here IGST, IGI, this is your account key, and against this account key we have linked the GL. Now save this. So now we have created, guys, we have created 12% tax code, 12% we have created for input, 12% input. Okay, see here 12% input we have created. Now 12% input has been created in two form. If intrastate movement is there, then 6%, 6%, and if interstate movement is there, then 6%, only 12%. That is in case of input. And again, the same thing is there in case of output also. Input means if vendor is going to charge, output means if you are going to charge from your customer. So once again, 12% code we have to create for output also twice. So I'll do one thing, I'll create. Now I'll just create for output, will give O1. Press enter so that we can understand O stand for output and I stand for input. Now here 12% CGST, SGST, and here we are going to give output. You have to give output. Okay, and now this is output. So what will be the tax type? It will be A. See here, for output A, and then press enter. Now 12% CGST and SGST, and that too in output. So where is output? We are having output condition types here, CGST and SGST. 12% means half will goes to central government and half will goes to state government. So 6%, and here also 6%. Press enter and you can save this. Now we have to create for output also, we have to create one more integrated, that is O2. Press enter and here IGST and here make it output. Okay, and make it A. Output means A. If you click on drop down, once again you will come to know tax type will be A. In case of output, the tax type will be A. Press enter. Now here you just give output. Here you have to give 12%, so 12. Press enter IGST output and save it. Okay, so what we have done, we have created only 12% tax code, guys. In the same way, we have to create 5%, we have to create 18%, and we have to create 28% also. Okay, so you can see how many tax codes we are going to create. For one 12%, we have created 4 tax code, 2 for input and 2 for output. Likewise, for others also, we have to, for each percentage, we have to create 4 tax codes. Now remaining, you can create, that will be a kind of assignment for you guys. It's pretty easy. The similar and the same steps you also have to repeat, you have to follow. And in that way, you can create remaining tax codes also. So now what we have done, we have created 12% tax code. Now see what next. So now we have created tax code. Now we have to do one more. Changes, we have to edit the GL account. Okay, GL account means if it is sales revenue GL or purchase GL, like if it is input, then in that case we have to edit purchase GL, and if it is output, then sales revenue GL, or whatever the, you know, for input all the expense GLs we have to edit, and for this one revenue GL we have to edit. So in revenue we are having only sales revenue right now, so we are going to edit that and we'll show you guys. So we'll have to edit. Why we are going to edit also, that I'll explain. /NFS00. Okay, and in that double click on sales revenue GL, and here click on edit button. So I'll tell you guys, sales revenue account, when you are going to use sales revenue account, we are going to use this sales GL once you made any sort of sales to your customer. In that case only we are going to use this sales revenue GL. Now what will happen in sales revenue GL, whenever we are going to post a transaction, then we always have to deduct output taxes only. We cannot apply any input tax, because input tax is going to be charged by your vendor. Whatever GST is charged by your vendor, that will be treated as an input tax, and whatever GST you are going to charge from your customer, that will be treated as an output tax. So sales revenue means we are going to sell something. Whom you are going to sell? You are going to sell these all the goods or services to your customer. So whatever tax we are going to collect from customer, that will be treated as an output tax. So in sales revenue GL, what we have to do, we have to apply in tax category. We have to apply, see here, only output tax allowed. I have given plus. If you give plus symbol, it means only output tax allowed. It means if you are going to post any transaction against sales revenue GL, sales revenue GL or sales GL, and in that, like while posting a transaction by mistake, instead of 12% output, if you have selected 12% input, then what will happen? Entire calculation is going to wrong. Okay, entire calculation is going to be wrong, and it is going to hit a different GL. Okay, so in order to avoid those kind of mistakes and error, what we have to do, you must have to assign this tax category here in sales revenue GL, so that it is, if you assign this one, only output tax allowed. It means by mistake also, if you have selected any input tax tax code, system will not consider that. Okay, system will not consider that. System will allow only output tax. So what is happening here? There is a 0% chance of making mistake. Okay, these are the specialty of SAP. Okay, these small validations or checks, you can say, and because of that, it is going to reduce the possibility of mistake. Almost it is going to reduce by 0%. Okay, so here this is the use of this tax category. I've used plus. Now if you talk about input taxes, then in your expense GL, let's suppose we are having rent or audit fee or purchase, whatever the GLs are there, in that you have to apply, you have to give minus here instead of plus. If you give minus, see, I'll show you minus and press enter. So in that, only input tax will be allowed. So now I'm going to give plus because sales belongs to our output. Like on sales, we have to deduct output tax. So I've given plus and then save it. Press enter to avoid this. Now, so we have done. We have done with our settings. Entire configurations are done. Now what we have to do? Now it's time to test. Okay, now it's time to test whether whatever configurations we have done is working perfectly or not. It means what we have to test, whether our 12% calculations are happening or not, and in case of interstate movement, intrastate movement, and whether it is going to hit whatever GL we have created to respective GL, the transaction codes. Okay, so now is the time of testing. We'll check the tax calculation is happening in our the way we have configured these things or not, and the calculation is happening correctly or not, and apart from this, whether it is going to hit the respective GLs or not. So we'll check one by one. Now, so open a new screen, and since we have done this settings for sales revenue, so we'll use FB70. FB70, press enter, and then we have already created one customer, that is 100246. That is a customer for our company code. Give date here. Okay, it's okay. Now, so this date I have given, current date, and then amount, let's suppose any amount, like whatever amount you want to give, you just give this amount. Okay, and then we have to give sales revenue GL also. So here 3002 is our sales revenue, and the same amount we have to give here. Okay, and then click on calculate tax and let's see what impact is happening. Okay, here we have to give 2018 actually. So now system is asking that required a valid tax code. Here system is saying that you need to give a tax code. Okay, so this is output tax. Now here user has to decide whether they are going to apply IGST or the combination of CGST and SGST, That will be decided by user. So whenever it's like whenever the invoice is getting printed on that itself, it will be like let's suppose if it is interstate, then it will be IGST intrastate CGST plus SGST. So now what will happen? Just click here on drop down and let's see the tax codes. So we are having total 4 tax codes are there, out of which we have to decide. Now it is, see here. So if it is sales, so it will be always output, and if it is intrastate, then this 12% CGST plus SGST. It's very simple to decide, guys. If it is interstate, then output, and which output? CGST plus SGST 12%. Or else if it is, sorry, if it is interstate, then IGST, and if it is intrastate, then CGST plus SGST. Okay, and we have to select output only. We cannot select input. Even if you select input, let's suppose select input. And let's see what is happening. If you have given I2, I2 is nothing but I stand for your input. Okay, press enter and let's see whether system is going to consider this or not. We'll see here itself what is happening. Okay, it's taking little bit time because in background lots of searches are happening. System is going to validate lots of things. And then, so first time it takes time, later on it will not take much time. Okay, so guys, that's what I wanted to show you guys. See here what is happening here. This GL is output tax relevant GL. It means in that GL what we have done, we have already given in if you see the GL of this one, if you see this one here in sales revenue, we have said like only output tax allowed. Okay, now what we have done, let's suppose user by mistake, the user, what user has done, user has assigned this tax code, that is I2 stand for input tax. Okay, input, if you see here I2 is nothing but your input, and that too 12% IGST. Okay, this is your 12% IGST is there, that we have assigned by mistake. Okay, so even if you made the mistake also, what will happen here? System has not considered, sorry, see here, system is not considering this. What system is saying? That only output tax is allowed for account 3002. System clearly it's saying that only output tax is allowed. And what we have given? We have given input tax. So now here what you have to do? You have to give only output tax. Now in output tax, here what we have to do? You have to decide whether it is interstate or intrastate. For this, we are not having any kind of this one. For this, system cannot identify whether this 12% is correct or this 12% is correct. In this case, what you have to do? You have to apply your common sense, and you know, like user know. You in the sense I'm talking in terms of user, that is there, this one, mistakes and all, if they made any mistakes and all, then they are going to do some different, you know, reversals and all will be happening. That is a different case. So here, let's suppose this 12% CGST plus SGST, if it is applicable. So select this one. Okay, now it means output 101, press enter, and then we'll do one thing, click on simulate, and we'll check what is happening. Okay, this is, cancel this. So at now what we have done, we have selected our tax code here at GL line item label, and here also you have to do one more thing, click on calculate tax. And here also we have to select this one. This is 12% CGST plus SGST if it is intrastate movement. If it is intrastate movement, and then click on simulate. Now see guys, here if you click on simulate, what is happening? Your customer is getting debited. Your sales revenue account is getting credited. Till here it's okay. And now what is happening? See, the GST input, sorry, GST out, CGST output and SGST output. This is also being calculated here, CGST output and SGST output also, and see the GL number. Now, CGST output and SGST output 2001 and 2002. If you want to check the GL account whether it is going to hit correct GL account or not, so see here CGST output and SGST output. This is the GL which we have created. Okay, these are the GL which we have created for CGST and SGST 2001 and 2002. So this GL is appearing here. It means 6%, 6%, the same amount is going to 2001 and half 6% is going to this GL 2001 and 2002. Okay. Now what will happen here? Now what will happen? 2001 and 2002. These are the two GL which is being it. So here, if you talk about logic, okay, if you talk about logic, how system is going to identify, how system is going to identify that the respective GLs and all. What is the logic working behind this? So I'll tell you guys. See, whenever I'll just click on back button. Whenever we post a transactions, okay. So see, this is our company code. Okay, so from here system is going to identify your country. Okay, system is identify your country. System will identify your country. Okay, now then against country, against your country, system is going to search what is the calculation procedure. I already told you guys OBBZ is the transaction code. From your company code, system is going to identify your country. Okay, from your company code, system identified your country, and from there, see, if you give your country code IN, then from country in background, system is going to search in that country code or in that country which tax procedure we have assigned, that is TM10. Okay, in TM10, if you talk about GL account, how system is going to derive GL account. So system, first of all, whenever we post any transaction, system is going to identify your company code, and this company code is created against which so against this company code is created against which country. From that country in background, system is going to check against this country which tax procedure has been assigned. See here, system identify the tax procedure, then select tax procedure OBQ3. Then in background itself, system is going to identify, okay, the same, I think, tax procedure we have opened somewhere, that is why it is saying that locked, it's here. So now in OBQ3, so system is going to check in background against this tax procedure. Okay, these are the tax procedure. Now, so here system identified the tax procedure. Now here, what is happening while posting a transaction? Which tax code we have selected? Okay, so that tax code is O1, that is output. Okay, 12% CGST and plus SGST. Okay, so this CGST and SGST. So here O1 is nothing but your tax. We have created a tax code. In that tax code, so once you give the tax code, once you give the tax code, I'll just let you know here, FTXP, FTXP, and our country is IN. So we have given, let's suppose O1 we have given. This is our tax code. So in O1, system is going to search in O1 what is the tax percentage. So 6% is for this CGST and 6% for SGST. So this is how system is going to divide the amount. System is going to divide the amount. This one is the correct one. In two part, here and here. But which GL is going to be responsible for this amount and which GL is going to be responsible for this amount? So here itself, if you see the tax procedure, here we have assigned the account key also is linked. Okay, against this condition type, this is the account key which are linked. If you see here in tax procedure, CGST and SGST for output, these are the account key which we have linked. CGO and SGO, that is what is appearing here in tax percentage also, CGO and SGO. And against this account key, what we have done, against this account key we have linked two different GL account. Which GL account? Click on tax account here. You will come to know your chart of account is TM10. Press enter. These are the two GL accounts which we have linked. And what transaction code we have used to link this GL account? OB40. OB40 is the transaction code by which we have already linked these two GL accounts. This is how system is identifying the GL account. If somebody asks, like, if you post any transaction, how system is going to identify the GL account? So you have to say, like, that first of all, system is going to identify, you know, from company code, system is going to identify the country code. From country code, system will identify which tax procedure is there, and then system is going to read the tax code also. The tax code also, here the tax code we have given, whatever the tax code we have given, that is the tax code we have given Q1, sorry, O1, that one is our tax code. So this tax code we have given, from tax code system is going to identify in tax code, like, your account key is also going to appear. Okay, so from that account key, against that account key, which GL we have linked. So that is how system is going to identify the GL account. Okay, so this is the logic, guys, to identify the GL account. And here we'll have to post this. I'll just post this transaction. See, the transaction got posted. And if you want to check the balances, FBL3N, you have to use to check the balances, like /NFBL3N. If you want to see this GL balance, click here. So one amount came to this one, your this GL account, CGST output account, and we are having SGST output account also. Make it 2 and once again execute. So in SGST output account also half amount has appeared. And if you want to post any transaction for IGST, if you have to post any transaction against IGST, then what will happen for IGST? Once again, just come on this. Okay, this screen is not working, so we'll have to come here, click on escape. For IGST, what we have to do, once again you have to use /NFB70. And once again, you have to post the transaction. Once again, you have to post the transaction. And here in tax code, you have to select this 12% IGST. So here, this, whether it is interstate movement or intrastate movement, that will be decided by user. Okay, that system is not going to, system is going to differentiate between input and output. Okay, that's what this in GL account, that setting we have done, that is the use of, that is the logic behind giving that settings. So now if you have to post IGST and all, in the similar way you can post IGST also. And whatever remaining tax codes are there, 12%, sorry, except 12%, like 12% I have done, 5%, 18% and 28%, that will be a kind of assignment for you guys. You can do from your side and then you can see how the impact is happening. So that's all in GST part, guys. That's all in tax on sales purchase. As I said, tax on sales purchase is for indirect tax configurations. It has taken too much time, because I just wanted to finish this topic is one go, so that the momentum will continue. Okay, and now if you talk about interview question and answer, what kind of questions people are going to ask, what you have to reply, these all things will be shared later. A separate session will be shared for interview question and answer. In that, I have compiled all the questions which is being asked during interview and what answer you have to give. So it is going to make your entire thing very simple, very simple. Okay, so don't worry about this. Just have a good practice. See the logic, whatever I explained here right now. If you are able to understand these all logic, then whatever questions also I'm going to share, that is also going to be easy. And you will be able to understand the answer very easily. So that's all in this session, guys. We'll close this session here itself. Okay, guys, we'll close this session here itself. See you tomorrow. Bye bye. Have a good day.